So all my adults, I think since 2014, they actually come from a poet, from the words of a poet, Dorothy Molloy. And in one poem by her, she talks about this eclipse plumage. Eclipse plumage basically is a natural process that happens to ducks, to actually drakes, so the male duck. So basically they lose all the flying feathers all at once. They lost them all, and for about 6 weeks they cannot fly. But what happens is that the flying feathers, they are the colorful ones, okay? And so when they lose them all at once, they basically look exactly like a female drake, so they get completely brown, and it's very, very dangerous. So first of all, I'm a huge feminist, so for me it was very nice to see that there was a natural process in which male and female, they all looked alike, so that you could just not see and say who was the male and who was the female. But also the piece comes from another piece, and that is why I wanted to actually use this title, because it's almost like this piece lost all these flying feathers, and now it's more closer to this one. Yeah, so they actually look alike. So the anti-machine is a machine that I built with this visual artist engineer that actually lives here in Berlin, Jan Bernstein, and we collaborated actually on several projects. So basically, I think that the e-bows normally, they are beautiful instruments, not powerful enough. So what we created was simply like a possibility to have a magnetic fields around the strings of a piano or whichever metal strings that allow the strings to start to vibrate, and then you can modulate this. And it works very, very well also on low sounds, etc. So it's basically an enormous e-bow machine. That was what it was very interesting. So normally there is actually Daniel Walden that plays the anti-machine so that I hear much better how it sounds. But because of coronavirus, etc., we couldn't fly him here, and so I did it. In any case, what you get is almost like the sine waves. So they absolutely have this electronic quality, I would say. So definitely it sounds a bit like electronics, but there's not electronics whatsoever. In the piece, there is also some electronics, of course. Inside the piano, there is not. But whether you recognize what you hear and you can associate it with the instruments that I'm using, that is not really the aim. But of course, I think that in all my pieces, there is always the doubt that I put, I mean, not consciously, but like the doubt that the listener has, who is playing and what are they playing, you know, yeah. What I did last year with this anti-machine is that I made an installation and I asked the people to play the machine. So they would come and just like play with it, because at the beginning you don't really understand how it works, etc. But if you start to just like play with the knobs, etc., and you understand that basically the vibration of the string changes its speed, etc., that is really interesting. And all of a sudden they understood the process and how they could just, you know, play with it, yeah.
Thank you. Thank you.